In the ghost kitchen race, GV-backed Kitchen United aims to kill with kindness. Here's its playbook. Cloud kitchens, ghost kitchens, dark kitchens. No doubt by now you know a little about these businesses that are moving into underused or more affordable properties that can be turned into shared workspaces for the purposes of cooking up meals exclusively for delivery. You probably also know that former Uber CEO Travis Kalanick has been at the forefront of the trend for more than a year, growing his cloud kitchens business as fast as he can, fueled in part by $400 million that he quietly raised from the Sovereign Wealth Fund of Saudi Arabia earlier this year. Sometimes these are in the U.S., in so-called opportunity zones or lower-income areas that, under the Trump administration, are enabling businesses to set up shop and avoid federal taxes in exchange. Kalanick is also reportedly eyeing big moves into both India and China. Cloud Kitchens has competition, though. In fact, among a growing number of rivals, its fiercest competitor is Kitchen United, a Pasadena, CA, based outfit that has raised roughly $56 million to date from investors including GV, Fidelity, and the real estate operating companies Diveco West and RXR Realty, among others, and which has turned down hundreds of millions of dollars more for the time being. Does its founder, a tech veteran turned restaurateur Jim Collins, not understand the opportunity before him? It was one question among many that Collins answered last week at a Strictly VC event in San Francisco where he dazzled the crowd with his comic timing and his tactics. The interview, conducted by former TechCrunch editor and now CNBC reporter Laura Kolodny, also provided one of the best overviews to date of what this fast-ballooning industry is really about. If you're interested in the future of how food is made and delivered, and who could win and lose in the process, this is an interview you should read to the end. On Collins's background. I did tech companies for a bunch of years and sold the last one off about 10 years ago, and I said I never want to work with venture capital people again. Laughs, that's sort of true but not completely. Honestly, I was burned out, it was a grind. One day, there was a restaurant up the street for sale. I walked up the street and bought the restaurant and then came home and told my wife, I bought the restaurant. And so we had a conversation that, the decision, might entail a lifestyle change where I was going to be gone every night, and I was at the restaurant every night for about a year and a half getting it going, but I absolutely fell in love with the restaurant business. On how he came to run Kitchen United, as well as run his restaurant, which is still a going concern. Our restaurant is in Montrose outside of Los Angeles, in a sleepy commune. For more on this story, visit the news article link.